Hey everyone, Julian here from the Institute of Digital Dentistry, and I'm here at the Straumann booth with Florin, the founder of SmileCloud, to talk about the release here at IDS 2023. So Florin, tell me, give me a bit of a look at the background of the software and why you made it.
Well, pretty much my background has always been clinical, so I've always been, you know, like boots on the ground treating patients and been involved in education in digital dentistry for quite a long time. And obviously every technology out there exists to solve problems, right? So the problems that we saw in all this time, one was the fragmented data, which is lying around on different devices and is communicating peer to peer, which is obsolete for today. I mean, in every other field, we want a centralized data platform, and obviously we want that this is cloud and ideally web-based. And this is the first thing that we put on the table. And then obviously we approach the idea of design, and we went into Smile Design, where I think as differentiators, what we brought to the table is high level of automation with the use of AI, and high level of photorealism, which means you get a lifelike, you know, look. And last but not least is this idea, and probably the biggest pitch, is the use of biometric data, which means, in simple words, natural tooth shapes. And essentially, we do design as a search engine for anatomy that renders in real time how different composition of teeth would look. And the beautiful thing about it is that it doesn't just output a simple picture, it outputs also the anatomy, so you can go to the other software and have a follow-up of what you design and show to the patient.
So we've got a patient communication tool as well as a collaboration tool and AI to improve and speed up design.
Exactly.
That's very exciting. So SmileCloud was previously an independent company, and you've recently had Straumann invest.
Yes. The thing is, at some point, it's the bigger picture that becomes more important. We have to see that what we can do on our own, and I think we're happy with what we did and with what we're doing. But we're equally excited to play a bigger game in terms of real change. And for that, I think a partner like Straumann makes a lot of sense because of all the synergies we can create together. And actually, this partnership is very special because it's very uncommon that there is almost like zero overlap between what the companies offer. It's very complementary, and it's also, in terms of vision of the people, equally important, I think. We have a very good fit, so I'm happy for this.
I'm excited to see. We literally had some conversations with other people about who's going to tackle the software game of integrating with lots of different systems and making the game of import and export between software get fixed, and it looks like you're tackling that.
Yes, we will obviously be competing for that role, and I think we're in a good position for that. All the context and all the pieces.
So integration-wise, do you integrate with a lot of practice management systems yet?
At this point, we focus not so much on practice management systems, but on giving more use cases for the user, which is we want to integrate with guided surgery, which is what we announced now with Straumann, with Co-Diagnostics. Then we're going to integrate ortho and eventually CAD. PMS will come, but will be at a later stage, and for a very pragmatic reason. The PMS market is very fragmented. So in order to have a real impact, you really need to go and consolidate, and it's more complicated, let's say.
Yeah, very different region to region, country to country, different healthcare systems. It's a big challenge. Yeah. Oh, that's exciting. So currently we've got the implant workflow happening, and the ortho is going to be coming later this year?
Aspirationally, yes. But remember, you're asking a product person, not a development person. So we always want to get it as fast as possible. But I would say, realistically, probably first, I mean, an initial level might happen this year, but we will not achieve the all 9 yards this year for sure. We need more depth there a little bit.
Yeah, there's a lot of development that goes in there, so I'm certainly aware. So what's the time difference that in clinical time benefit that someone has by using the software right now?
In simple words, what we put on the table is simplicity. So in this sense, I think everything that we currently have as an offering is significantly faster than alternatives. And to give you the example of a design, you can literally do a design right now in 4 clicks, and we're going to get it down from those four.
Four is too many, hey?
Four is too many because we want that the user starts at from a draft already, and what he invests in the process should be only depth. So there should be almost like instant to the actual process. We don't want preliminary steps. We want that you start from a depth, from a draft, and from that point on you only invest in depth, which is obviously an individual decision.
Okay, that's pretty exciting. And then in terms of production, with 3D printers and other output devices, are you doing anything there?
Further down the line, there are some things planned, but it's too early to discuss about that. Again, in the bigger picture.
So right now we can export an STL and bring it into our slicing software and print?
Yes, right now you export it and you just go to a 3D printing software and it's not a direct connection, but it's all the freedom and, let's be honest, it's not really a complicated thing to do.
Yeah, so speaking of the openness and freedom, is this available for any implant system or just Straumann's range?
Let's say that the goal of both companies is to stay open, but obviously in our collaboration we will prioritize obviously what we can do together first, and after that of course we will promote openness. Or let me put it this way, openness is not something that will ever change. It's just the priorities, obviously strategically there are some things we need to consider.
That's great to hear, because obviously many people can benefit from it, and the guided surgery market is still only in the, you know, less around 25% mark from the numbers I hear. So many more people can benefit from guided surgery.
Yes. Yes.
Look, thank you for your time. Very exciting, and great to meet you.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.